So where are we now? Who drove past on a... Hello, turtle friend. Chapter 4, pond. Okay, is that what this is? A pond? Well, we're headed for a pond. Keep hearing, like, automobiles or something. I'm only guessing I'm supposed to be walking this way and not that way. Well, I'm glad we're out of spooky time. I hope we stay out of spooky time.
One evening, Eric bought me a bouquet of betonies. I asked, from where and why?
No questions.
He didn't respond to my question. Touched my hair, scanned me from head to foot, but still said nothing. Walked away to his studio room, turned on his PC. He started playing his favorite FPS game, Modern Offensive.
Modern Offensive.
After a couple hours, he was done playing, so came back to me and said, I don't care about the violence in games. Just wish it was only in virtuality. Maybe it's time we go to bed now. He was a difficult person to understand.
Virtuality? You mean like virtual reality? So he'd rather have violence in a virtual reality than in a game. And you married him, why? Oh wait, yeah. You were married, right? I haven't seen the guy for a while. I wonder if you could miss him. I mean, I don't actually miss him, but you know what I mean. Maybe an achievement for finding all the letters. But I haven't seen him. If I walked...
Here I go again. Where's that freaking pill?
Here it is. What happens if I don't take it? Do I just stay like that, or does... Do we get to an end state? There's a very odd tint at this point. What is this pill doing for you?
I remember we were children, running in the fields with bare feet all day and going back home for supper. He used to tell me his dream about us, walking together in Victorian gardens. I always thought those dreams would come true someday. Even if there would be no garden, we'd definitely be together.
Oh, wow.
Sooner or later, those dreams would come true.
Wow.
If I knew how to ride a horse, this journey would take a lot less.
Are we supposed to try to catch one of them or something? I clicked it. Nothing happened. This might just be something she's wishes for but cannot have. Oh, ducks? Am I hearing ducks?
I heard there are new F12 model cameras. Should give it a try someday.
Where are we going to find a camera around here? Thought I heard ducks, but the music is so loud right now over it. And I don't see them. So where am I supposed to be going? Well, I'm hearing geese. I don't see them. And I see one bird. And I hear a lot of geese flying overhead or something. Is that a car? Oh, there they are. I want the car. All right, fine. Yeah, I hear you now. Am I going this way? I mean, it's really not letting me get up to the water. What's that there? Oh, just more rocks. I saw a horse, and this horse was mine. Except no, it was guarded by an invisible force field. Oh, crap. Fine, be that way. Am I supposed to be going this way?
Eric wasn't exactly a mingy type, but when it came to cars,
mingy?
I could never persuade him to buy a new one. He loved his old wreck. Said his father gave it him on his 18th birthday, right after he graduated. It was sky blue, his favourite colour, and looked like a dead man walking. I remember its engine stopped working so many times. Those moments he never panicked. Got out of the car and fixed the engine in 10 minutes tops. Mechanics was kind of his speciality.
Speciality? Should that have played when we got near the other car, instead of then?
At the college, we were at the same class. One day, it was literature exam, and the teacher was about to see him cheating from the book. I saw that and started to sing with a loud voice. The teacher got mad and took my paper, so Eric got enough time to copy all the answers to his paper. Later, he couldn't decide to whom he had to feel more guilty, but when the school ended and I failed the class...
Why do I feel creeped out again? Supposed to be doing something around here? Oh, there's the creepy guy again. Hello, creepo. Seeing me stare at your innocent eyes, you can call me jerk. But who is the real jerk if you're stalking me when I'm alone at home? Well, not only that, but when you're out walking around in creepy places. Be it a stalker, be it a desperate lover turning ashes from fistful of flowers found in a Victorian garden, excuse me, which I will never be able to visit in this life, full of invisible walls, yeah, like the walls I keep running into. In the end, the only thing to do is pray to whoever there is, not to be forgiven, but to get the feedback you deserve about your mistakes. So he's stalking her, or is it her dead husband? I mean, I don't know if that's the husband. She never seems to remark on anything when we see him. That's left up to me. I don't know where I'm supposed to be going. Are we supposed to be heading back home now that we have the flower? So we took the boat back and now we're walking around here? I mean, obviously we're not returning back the same way we had come. St- Still no drizzle and no path. Unless this is a path winding all through this.
What if we never met? I'd probably throw myself into the wild many more times than I actually did. He wasn't so into the nature. Hmm. Especially he was afraid of forests. The trees felt like giant monsters to him. I am quite the opposite to that. I find peace in the shadow of the trees. When I was a child, my father built me a tree house, and Eric never came near it.
I caught a
fleeting
glimpse.
He used to say, "You're going to fall and die, and when you do, remember what I say." He was trying to keep me secure, even when he was a child.
When he was a child? Can I go up there? Oh, this thing disappears.
What?
Yeah, I don't know what it is about that. I found two of those now. Yeah, we can't climb that, so I would say not. Boop. Was that just rocks? Looking around for stalker, dude. I think those are just rocks. Oh, there is a house up there. And the door is open. I don't think we can get up on there. That's annoying. Alright. Yeah, it's a little creepy. Alright, perhaps going... I don't even know. That ends there this way? Speeding up. Here we go. Over there. Or is it a barn or something?
Since I am at the center of wild nature, of course there will be a subway station. I'll have a look inside.
Right in the middle of all this? Yeah, of course there'll be a subway station. And look at us with no tokens. Crimes and Daggett Legal Services. This is unexpected. Winston's Happy Hour Pub and Grill. Potato chips. Swift experience. Mm. 14th Street Station, Uptown Brooklyn? We're in New York City.
Okay. Let's drink for being alone.
We're gonna have a drink? Wi-Fi here. Check your wireless device. You can now connect. I'm just gonna look around a little bit first, obviously. Actually getting stuck on stuff here. Yeah, we're gonna have a random drink that someone just left on the table. Okay. I drank it, now what? Oh. I need my pill. Am I supposed to be taking the pill with alcohol? Oh.
What is this place? Am I losing it?
I think it's just lost, girl. I think that's it. Not losing. Completely lost. Oh. The ground is forming beneath us as we go. Okay. Oh. Okay. Does this always happen to her when she has a drink? Okay. Is this the path to sobriety, I guess? If we fall off, I think we go back to the beginning back there. That's not the way then. Is this the way of the AAA meeting? They told me that I was supposed to come here. Brother. Anybody here? Am I hitting? I won't fall off this thing. Whatever. Things. Tree. Am I supposed to jump for the tree branch? Oh, brother.
A tree? Makes no sense. I think I'm going to fast forward from here to the hill where the grave is.
You can do that? Okay. Sounds like a plan. Oh. Chapter 5. Hill. Hill, 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 hill.
No. I can't just go through an invisible wall.
It won't be the first one you've seen in this walk. Can't go to an invisible wall. Whee! Why is there no invisible wall there like on the other cliff? So you can just fast forward through your drunken dream. Wish I could do that.
Years ago, we had been to Iceland. Coming back home near the airport, I was walking so fast, I didn't see a cab coming my way. There was no time to alert me, so he jumped into the air to push me, just like in the movies. Naturally, we both ended up in the hospital with a total of 6 broken bones.
Each?
It's nice listening to his dreams every day in the bed. Mr. Adams, the doc, didn't want to discharge us from the hospital for some reason.
What reason is that? So 6 bones.
We weren't afraid
each
of heights.
Together.
Climbed high hills and even a mountain once. Eric didn't mind, as long as there are not so many trees. And loved to take photos of distant skies.
Him and the trees.
When it drizzled, I used to sing. And since his voice was terrible, he just played the bouzouki he got from Mykonos Island. Together,
bouzouki?
We even wrote a song for his car. The car that lived longer than Eric.
Huh. What about the Mountain of Fire? Did we climb the Mountain of Fire?
On a rainy day, we were going to visit Lara's. While Eric was driving, I asked him, "What if lightning strikes the car? Will the tires protect us?" He said, "It's just a myth. The reality is, yes, we're safe, but what's saving us is the car's metal cage." There, he did it again. I didn't talk to him that day. Thankfully for him, Lara was with us, and Eric didn't even notice my attitude.
Oh, he's too interested in Lara, huh? Okay, I guess better not try to go down there. Where's this grave? Up there, by the tree? You really put his grave by a tree when you scared the death of trees? So to speak? He has his fear of trees, but he can put his grave by a tree. I hope not. That'd be your way of having the last laugh now, wouldn't it? Oh, there he is! Creepo! Hello, Creepo. Tired of being the king of apologies for eternity. Funny to think it would make impression that I would give up. Some people are nice. Others try to please the confident shooters. Some like to collect their crappy trophies, while others only think about getting higher ranks. She is the only ruler among the stars. I would grant all the badges if I could, just to see a tiny sign of consideration. Sometimes a jerk, too, can drown deeper than an infinite universe. If he wrote this stuff, I have no idea what he's talking about. I'm glad the cheerful guitar music is back, though. So his grave is not by the tree. Good. Good choice. Does this mean we've come full circle? We're just gonna find the grave now and then do our thing and then the end?
Life is so empty since he passed away. Everything feels like going up the hill. And I feel so close to the end. Am I ever going to see you again? Honestly, I'm not sure about what would have been my wish. And I don't know if you want to see me wherever you are. Deep inside, I miss you so much. But I try hard not to. Life changes all of us. But some things are always the same. Can being a bad dev who can't script proper AI be an achievement for anyone? If it was 2 years ago, I couldn't find the right answer for that.
A bad dev. We're going down there, okay. You really have to put this grave in the middle of nowhere.
Lara always talks about Mr. Adams. She says the guy is so cool. But Eric used to mock Lara about it. He said, the only way you talk to him is to get hit by a car.
Nah.
Eric loved to make Lara frustrated.
Who's Mr. Adams?
Even when she was at college, he used to steal her books and return them after exams.
A professor?
I used to talk to him a lot about the situation, but he kept on resisting. Nothing changed, even though long years have passed in our lives.
Seems like we are to go this way. Maybe we are going down that way. No. Wait, this way. Oh.
One more pill and that will do, I guess.
Yeah, don't fall off the edge. Look, Ma, no fences. Oh, brother.
Seaplanes, cars, bazookies, and so many more. It's been so long since I lost him, but it feels like everything reminds me of him. I'm here, and he's on the other side. There is just one bridge between us. It's called death. I'm not afraid of seeing the other side, even if there is no return. And all my senses tell me that it is near. Should I pay him a visit? Would he want that? Sooner or later, I will find out.
Looks like a guy standing a man's length. Well, pay him a visit, like his grave? Because we've been doing that for the entire time. And you're just questioning that now. What do you mean, pay him a visit as in you're gonna die? Yeah, it's like a person's legs. Is his grave here? Because that would be weird. Where are we supposed to be going? Going to his grave, or are we going to go jump in the water and die? There's kind of a dead end here. Unless I've taken the wrong turn, I don't know. Oh wait, no, there's more down here. Okay, never mind. Kinda just looks like we're about to drop off the edge. It's over here. More endless. Just think, someone had to carry his body all this way. And the coffin, I'm assuming, as well. That does not seem very reasonable. I'm guessing not up there, but rather this way.
Cross the bridge, and we're there.
Okay. Really? After all, this is a bridge. Oh. With like a brazier burning on top? It's fancy. Get away, you blasted birds. A stone archway. is his grave down there. Can we go in this structure? Nope, it's locked. That's a happy gargoyle. And a battle mage, I guess. Alright, so I guess we are going down there.
Let's find the grave, since I totally forgot which one it was.
Such a good wife you are. We know where he's buried.
I love you, Eric. But that evening, well, I caught you staring at Lara in a different way.
I was right!
That moment.
Oh!
The shard of glass seemed so friendly.
You're spooky looking.
Sorry. Not once upon a time.
She killed him! The end. That was a little spooky in places. You're welcome for playing. Well, short and sweet. Creepy and stuff. Thanks for watching, guys. We got one more Drizzlepath game to play. Whether I play them consecutively or broken up, I'm not sure how it's going to turn out yet. But I did enjoy playing this one. There's some parts that were not very enjoyable, but the rest was pretty enjoyable. It's a lot more interactive than the second one. It was more interactive than the first two. But the first one took me like 30-something minutes to play. The second one took me like over 4 hours. So this is more short and sweet. So thanks so much for watching, guys. Hope to see you guys in another Let's Play. And always, seek adventure.